Good evening, everyone. My name is Sid, and I'm the founder of One App Cloud. A little background on One App Cloud and where I'm coming from. About 2 years ago, my background is in enterprise software, and about 2 years ago, I was part of another startup, and I used to talk to a lot of business users and IT people, and one of the problems that we identified back then, speaking with everyone, was everybody was getting tons of email. So I think all of us can relate to it. At work, email usage is, you know, I was talking to people who were getting north of a couple of hundred emails a day. So the big problem that we identified talking to them was, what do you do with this email? For everything I get a notification, I get an email. I'm using Excel spreadsheets for managing a lot of my processes. It becomes extremely hard to collaborate with spreadsheets. So what can we do with that? So that was the genesis of One App Cloud. We put in the cloud because, you know, it's all a SaaS-based solution. So basically what One App Cloud is that it's a business app creating platform with workflow capabilities and collaboration built in. So when you look at a tool like One App as a business user with no IT or technical experience, you can still create an application for your need, for your users, and share it. Let me jump quickly to the demo because you know, when you see how the form, how easy it is to collaborate and see an application built, you know, you can understand, you know, as a business user, anyone can use this. So we have forms, forms being the central piece. When I was watching the Jibecast demo, I could see some synergies with what you guys do with the video sharing. So essentially, the intent is for people to get away from email and maybe have a central place where all the collaboration can happen and all your workflow processes can be routed to this central channel. So we have it's a cloud-based tool, and anyone who has Google Apps or Gmail can automatically log in. So if you're a business, you can set up all your employees, you can have everyone just use Google Apps to log in. Right. So I'm already logged in, and essentially to create an app, it's as simple as starting with the UI. So I can go and start creating a form here. So I can pick and choose what fields I want to drag and drop on my forms. I can define rules. So the power of the tool is that you can start with something very simple, but as things progress, you know, you can add business rules, you can add routing logic, you can write, you can build in workflow control, all this without writing a single piece of code. So it makes this easy to build an application out, but there are certain companies that we work with who have developers and they want to extend the solution even more. So for them, we provide an interface where even developers can extend the solution by writing JavaScript and CSS right into the tool. So after I create a UI screen and I build in the workflow, what I see is as a user of this application, I have a universal inbox which shows me all the content that has been pushed to me. So I can see that there was an IT feedback and bug ticket that was assigned to me. As a user, I can collaborate right here. The person who's working with me can, again, comment back. I have real-time chat built in, so if there are more people live at the same time, I can start, initiate a chat session with them. Right. This makes it easy for people to collaborate at the center place. You know, I saw a lot of people are familiar with Yammer. What we are trying to do different here is we are focusing with certain group of customers. We're focusing on certain business processes, like we're working with a customer to do quality control process in stores. So they have users on iPads who are using the solution for doing the audit control. So the differentiators that we have built in compared to some of the other tools is that we have a lot of these out-of-box business apps that we have configured. These are available with the business rules, validations, and, you know, it's a more of a turnkey solution, so you can have users directly start using them. they have workflow integrated, they have the collaboration all built in, and they are mobile optimized. So it becomes a more complete solution for any customer to take it and roll it out within their company. So that's pretty much what I had to cover in terms of a demo. I can definitely take any questions that you may have.
You mentioned email in the beginning, people getting hundreds of emails a day. So I may have missed this, forgive me. I initially thought this is something that might be able to take emails as input, and that you could map the fields on the form to the email, so there would be a workflow of information that I might otherwise copy and paste from email and push through a work process, and that maybe this is a way of grabbing it from the email, but I'm not sure that that's true.
So the question is that, does the application parse emails from an email inbox and convert it to forms? So the answer is, it is in that direction. So I have, in the tool you see, I have a fetch email option here. What this lets you do is, it lets you connect your email inbox. But at the moment, the features that we have built in, that lets you analyze your inbox. You can see, in a day, you're probably getting a couple of hundred emails just for approvals, maybe. You know, if you're an IT director, if you have a lot of approvals coming your way, you can analyze that. So we are getting there, but right now we are in the stage where you can analyze based on the email traffic that you have, but which are the processes that need conversion.
So then what would be one or two popular use cases that if somebody would say, oh yeah, I can use that every day or once a week, or that would be really valuable. Are there a couple examples?
Yeah. So. Couple of examples where this could be used via an email. So depending on what kind of processes, there are a lot of sales-related ad hoc processes where sales, for example, if you're a sales executive and if you're a VP of sales, so you may have discount policies which are not in the system, you know. You may be getting discount, you know, questions via email from your sales manager saying, can I give this customer 20% discount, but he's going to close in this quarter. And you can configure some of those processes right here with these forms, where you can say, okay, the approval has to be routed to me. If there is a discount policy which is not defined, but I'll create a rule just for, as an exception for this customer. So those are some of the use cases for businesses.
Thank you.
You are.
Can you show us an example build out form? You started on
the question is, can we see an example of a filled out form? So let me jump back to the form builder. Let me take a very simple example, a feedback and bugs form. So I have a number of fields here, the description, severity, status, and there's an option of attaching an image as well. So when I come back, now this form is already published, so I'll show you the settings as well. So the form is published, and when I want to create a form, I'll click on the create link here, and this will let me create a form entry. So this is a bug, for example. I'll select severity, select some status, and I do a submission. Now when this happens, as you can see, the form entry gets created. Behind the scene, any of the workflow rules and triggers that you have configured, which may say that if the severity is high, for example, the previous question was, you know, we want to have a workflow with some approval mechanism configured for discounts. You can configure that. You can build in the rule that says, if a certain field has certain value, then it should be routed to this particular manager or this department. Right. And when the processing kicks in, yes, so we already have the form entry that we created that already came in the inbox. And now, depending on who is shared with, right now it's only shared with me, but depending on the rules that I've configured, if I share it with multiple people, again, this becomes a central point, you know. Think of it as, instead of that one email that you're applying to everyone, now this becomes a place where you all can collaborate. Now I can kind of post a question. And whoever is shared on this record will be able to see this and reply to it.
Any questions?
So there's
this form have any status reporting or any reporting of projects and jobs pending?
Correct. So the question is, does the form have any reporting built into it? So we have, reporting is also built into the tool. There's a way in which you can run some standard reports on any of the forms that are available. Again, there are some out-of-the-box reports available. You can always extend them, but there is extensive reporting provided. So you can get statistics on how many people completed the form, what the status of a particular form is, so on and so forth.
Any further questions? This looks like an entire group.
Wait a minute, how is this app being distributed? Is it client-based or can it be used with existing platforms?
Yeah, so the question is, how is the app distributed currently? It's a SaaS-based product, so it's all subscription-based on the cloud. You know, it's a browser-based application. What we have in terms of distributions, there's a cloud, public cloud version of it, but for some of the bigger customers, we also have private private cloud instances where they use this.
Would you consider licensing something like this to an existing platform?
Yes, we are actually, we are obviously, looking at various options. There are some implementations that we are doing where the solution has been taken in-house and we're integrating with existing solutions, like if there's a SharePoint installation within the premise, we're extending SharePoint with some of the functionality that we provide.
All right, any more questions? All right, one last question for you. How can the PTM community help you out? What are you looking for?
Just like everyone else here, looking for customers, some feedback, and obviously we're looking for investors as well.
Okay, give them an applause.